I'll show you corruption.
Ashim doesn't do anything.
I'll show you the corruption if you listen to me.
I wanted to play Ashim video for him yesterday. He ran away.
Okay, if you listen, you're not listening. You're listening. Do you know what a contradiction is? Contradiction. Contradiction. Let me finish. Sister, you're accusing me. Now, yeah. You've been debunked. You know, I debunked you now. Now you can. No, I debunked you. But I debunked you already. No, you can't give up. I debunked his sister here. Call me, he's going to show me. Come. Are you a Muslim? I'll show you Jesus is God. I debunked her now. Now she will keep crying.
Jesus is God. He's God.
Okay. Listen. Okay, listen to me.
You I'll show you the Bible. Where
let me talk. Why are you not saying? You see all these Bibles here. Do you believe all of them? Okay. Do you believe all these Bibles?
Yes, definitely.
You believe all of them?
The word of God.
All of them?
Yeah.
Okay, but you know this one said, this one here, that's what I'm saying. What is it? No, don't worry. This Bible here, no, let me finish. This one here say this is corrupted. What is that matter? Let me finish. This one say you believe in all this Bible. He said yes, as a word of God. No, let me finish. This one is corrupted. What do you say? It's corrupted. What do you say about that? No, finish that. No, don't digress. I ask you, you believe in all the. No, but
don't answer this.
No, but you said you believe in all the Bibles. These people are difficult. You believe them. I said they're not the same.
You didn't answer my question. Why should I answer yours?
You see, you're a waste of time. Now I'm going now because I finished it. I've been here. You're a waste of time.
So why are you talking about Bible?
You're a waste of time.
I'm not a waste of time. You people just, you don't know anything.
No, but you said you believe in all these Bibles. I said this one said this is corrupted. What do you say about that?
This one said this is corrupted.
Yeah. Open can it. I read it?
I don't care about whatever
it is. Yeah, it's a... Listen. What? Listen. Now, what's it? You are disingenuous. This man is insincere. You said, no. No, you don't know. No, you said you believe in all the Bible.
You are not getting to me.
No, you make me laugh. You know why you make me laugh? Because you said life now, you believe in all the Bible.
See,
I said, this one said, this is corrupted.
Every Bible, if you listen to me, every Bible, and I've told you to show me what corruption is. Divine corruption before I believe it.
Okay. Go there.
Divine corruption. Now let me see.
Divine corruption.
Yeah.
Okay, let me.
How it relates to this Bible.
No, okay. You want divine corruption? Let me see. Can you just call? We're debating. No, we're debating, sister. Sister, let's debate. If you want to debate with me, let me finish. No, let's finish. Here. No, yeah. Now define it. Hold on.
Listen.
Let me define it for you.
Let me just listen. Divine corruption.
Okay, and how it relates to
the verses of the Bible.
Okay, listen. Okay, let me listen.
Did you get it? Divine corruption and how
my African brothers and sisters are the most difficult Christians.
No, listen. I want to
Shumbum, Bookmun, Omun, Faum, Lair, June.
I want to guide you.
I want to guide you. Matthew 13:13. Seeing they see not, hearing they hear not, never will they understand. Jesus describing the Bible. Matthew 30. But he's not listening to me.
I just want you to divine it.
Let me talk then.
Divine the Bible.
Subhanallah.
Wait. Can we all keep quiet, please? The question is this. Can you divine the Bible? Corruption. Corruption according to how it relates to verses of all this.
Okay, wait. Okay, can you keep quiet? Don't interrupt me. Whatever I do, after if they're not satisfied, I can talk. Here. You see this Bible here? Keep quiet. Yeah, all these Bibles here, I've got so many Bibles. The brother said he believes in all of them. But this one here said the King James Bible is corrupted. No, listen. No, here. This one said this is corrupted. So you can answer here. Let me read it to you. That's who tell you corruption. They mean the corrupted. They give the meaning of corruption. He said here, yet the King James.
Who wrote this one?
Christian scholars of 32.
Let
32.
Before you proceed.
Look at this guy. No, I'm going.
Listen.
Okay, I'm going.
Listen. When he's not debating.
He's
not debating. When he wants to talk.
No, can you have a moderator?
There are.
Can we have a moderator? Moderator. 3 minutes. No. 3 minutes. Can someone help me, moderator? 3 minutes. Yes, 3 minutes.
There are some people.
Okay.
There are some enthusiasts.
By the time I finish with you, you'll go back to Africa. Wait. Wait. Yeah.
Stop that.
Stop that and start again. Stop that. Proper debate. Start one. Play for me. Yeah. Because this one is it recording now?
There are some
No. Let's have a moderator.
Let me educate.
No, moderator, 3 minutes. Are you scared? Are you scared? Okay, let's have a moderator. 3 minutes.
No,
each.
You can never listen.
No, no, I said.
No, Shamsi, I've tried that.
No, 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 he's not calming down. No, why not? Okay, no, 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 you're bad. Look, look.
He's running away.
Okay, we got time in here. 3 minutes each. No, no. No, 3 minutes each. No interruption. Prove to us that Jesus is God. There, 3 minutes each.
That Jesus is God.
And I'll debunk it. Simple. 3 minutes.
No. You can debunk it. Listen, 3 minutes. Let me educate you. According to the Word of God, the TOD, what they do here is general fallacies. Fallacy due to generalization. Listen, don't interrupt me. 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
Fallacy due to generalization.
I'm leaving now.
Please. Fallacy due to generalization. When you talk about God, G-O-D, and the Christians too should listen. When you talk about God, G-O-D, God was a word that was gotten from Elohim. And Elohim, what it means is someone that has power and authority.
Yes.
You understand? God is the title. It's not someone's name.
Yesterday.
You understand? So we have a lot of gods in this world. Who has power and authority?
Yes.
Right.
Jesus.
But we, for Christians, we have God of gods. Who call himself God of gods and Lord of lords. And he also is Almighty God. Listen, he's Almighty God. And when you wanted to write that, you write that with what? Capital G. You understand? But according to the definition of God Almighty, if you don't know, I will educate you today. According to the definition of God, which means someone who has power and authority. That is why you have God of thunder, God of the sea, God of the wind. There are a lot of gods in this world. Yes. Man-made ones and the paganism
yes,
gods.
Allah is a
so,
God.
But God Almighty said, God, there are many gods in this world, but my own God, I'm the God of every God, which is God of gods and Lord of lords. And he said in Exodus chapter 6, verse 3, he said to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I was known by my name, Almighty God, which means God of every other God. Right? In the context of the definition of God himself, Jesus Christ is God Almighty. I mean, Jesus Christ is God, not God Almighty. Jesus Christ is God, in the sense, slip of tongue. Jesus Christ is God, in the sense that he has power and authority. Please, read me Matthew chapter 28, verse 18. He makes a categorical statement, except if you don't believe in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ said that all power and authority has been given unto me, which he said, and people should know that Jesus Christ speaks in parable. When he said that all power and authority have been given unto me, he put himself in the position of a God. And that is why he called himself God Almighty. God.
God Almighty.
God.
Thank you.
No. Let me give you
30 seconds.
Because I asked you to divine God, you are going like
30 seconds.
He's gonna read that.
18. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. So that all authority, Jesus Christ telling them that I'm God, because God means what? Someone who has power and all authority.
No,
so that's
it.
3 minutes.
No, look, you finish it. Yeah.
Let me tell you,
no, no, no,
time.
All authority. Oh, no, look, it seems as if. Let me finish.
Before you respond.
Let me finish. You're not debating. Why are you coming?
No,
please. You're not debating.
Okay, we
got time. You got time. Your time will come. No, don't tell me. Let me tell you.
The same question.
The concept of God in Islam. I'll tell you that before I go. The concept of God.
Islam, generally.
Now the bank is. No, the concept.
Wait. Yeah. Bros, no.
Listen. Let me talk now. Why do you have respect, man?
No,
the concept, okay. This concept, listen to me. This concept of God in Islam, you find it in the Old Testament. And I'm going to quote to you, and I'm going to debunk you. And by the time I finish with you, I'm going to buy your ticket. You go to Africa. Wait. Yeah, I'll say that. Listen to me. The concept of God in Islam. Let me finish.
God, define God.
Let me talk first.
Is God.
You see this man. Last week, he had a debate with Shamsi. Shamsi, the same thing. He's not going to keep quiet. Give me 3 minutes. Look, we can debate for 45 minutes if you want, and I'll debunk it. Everything. Yeah, debunk it. Sunday, I'll debunk it. So, the Quran, if you go to Quran.
Time him now, 3 minutes.
See, we the Muslims.
I will go to the
I'm gonna walk away. If you want to debate, I'm going to walk away. I said, yeah, keep quiet. My 3 minutes going. After two debates, I'm tired. Two debates, you just come.
Sorry.
Yeah. So in Islam, we the Muslims are telling our Christian brothers and sisters in humanity that Almighty God is the only one Lord. In Islam, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the only one Lord, who has no partner, who created everything. And if you want to know the concept of God in Islam, the Quran has got 114 surahs. The 112th surah is called Surah Ikhlas. So that surah, let me quote it for you. It said, Kul huwa Allahu ahad. Say he's Allah the one. Allahu samad. Allah upon whom all depend. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. And there is nothing unto like him. You understand? We the Muslims, we worship the Creator, not the creation. You understand? A Muslim is someone who submits his will to Almighty God. Only one Lord, and not associating any partners to him. Anyone who worships, only one Lord, and not associating any partners to him, in Islam, in Arabic, is called Islam. It's simple. Yeah? So, now what I'm saying, we believe in Jesus Christ, peace on him. As a Messiah. Let me finish. I'll come to that. You said we go long. No, I'm good. It's my introduction. I'll come to that. In my introduction, I'll give you. I'll come to that. Don't run away. Introduction.
I will reply.
No, for people, for the benefit of viewers, so they don't know that, yeah, we believe in Jesus Christ, peace on him, as the Messiah, the prophet, center of children of Israel. He never said he's God. He never said worship me. Nowhere in the Bible. We're visiting all the prophets, and we do not make any distinction between the prophet. Any Muslim who makes a distinction with the prophet, you are not a Muslim. You are talking outside the fold of Islam. You know what I mean? So believe in Jesus. Yeah? In the Quran, that's it. So now the Christians are telling us now, let's go to you now, that Jesus Christ is God incarnate. And they believe in this Trinity. Yeah? This brother here, Muslim brother, doesn't believe that Jesus is God incarnate, is Almighty God. But she believes, she's a Trinitarian, believe that Jesus Christ is Almighty God. That's the thing. So you got a problem with you two here. So now we say that there's not a single verse in your Bible where Jesus said he's God, worship me. Listen to me. There is not a single verse in the Old Testament where God said he's a triune God. Not a single verse. God in your Bible. Very several verses. God speaks about his oneness. How about his uniqueness? Few of the passages I quote, the Christians run away from it. Let me quote them for you. If you read the Bible, in the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse number 10 to 11, God said, before me no God was formed. No shall there be any God after me. I am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. God is explicit. Besides him, there is no Savior. But you people are saying that Jesus is the Savior. So the question is, when did God change his mind? In the Old Testament. No, seven verses.
From his statement. Listen. From his statement, I asked him to divine God. He was only narrowing it to Islam. I know about Islamic God, which is Allah. Allah was derived from Ilah.
Yes.
And Ilah means the gods. Before Muslim. Ilah. I-L-A-H, I'm talking. Ilah, which means the gods. Let me tell you something. Right? Before Islam, there have been a lot of people worshipping paganism, the Uber as a nomad god, the 360 gods. No, the 360 gods in Mecca, what is it called? In Mecca. Definitely. So now I'm at the Kuba, Now he's talking about God. He has a divine God himself. That is why I said they keep on committing fallacy due to generalization. For you to know who is God, you have to know what the meaning of God is. Yes or no? For you to know who is God, you have to know the meaning of what God is. Yes or no? So he hasn't told me the meaning of God. He just jumped into Allah is God of. I know that Allah is God, like you said, and Allah means. No. I know from their meaning of Islam, they said that Allah is Almighty God. So if you mean that Allah is Almighty God, definitely let us hold by your own view, right? Hold by your own view. But you have not discussed who is God. I mean, what is God? So from the definition of what is God, let me educate you again. For the definition of what is God, God is derived from Elohim, which means someone who has power and authority. You understand? So anyone who has, that is why, let me give you an example. That is why God Almighty himself said to Moses that I will make you a God for Pharaoh.
Yes.
Does that mean that Moses is the God Almighty?
No.
No. But Moses was God at that point in time, when God sent him. And God said, and because God made him God, he was able to give some miracles. He was able to do some divine things. That is when Moses was God to Pharaoh. Likewise, Jesus Christ told the scribes and the Pharisees, because they have authorities over other Jews, he said that, don't you know that ye are God? That is the definition of God, God himself. But when he now comes to God Almighty, the difference is this. God Almighty is reference.
You see?
God Almighty
different from you.
Capital letter G. God Almighty is referenced with capital letter G, which is true. You understand? And it is someone who has authority. But to Jesus Christ, he said, all authority, all.
Oh.
All. That also making to be able, to be able to assimilate that that title of Almighty God.
What?
Understand? Yes.
Time.
I read it.
Time. These people are, you are so deluded. How do you mean? You are so deluded.
So what define?
No. Let me define God.
You don't understand what
listen
about.
To me. You are talking God. Listen to me. We are, look, this is a translation. Listen to me. Well, look, the translation here, you know, if I say, we worship Allah. Allah is the only one. When he said God, God is the English word. Jesus never spoke Aramaic.
God is.
No, listen God. To me. Listen, let me finish. Listen, you're Aramaic. I don't know where you are confusing yourself. God, small God, capital G, and he's, you know, he doesn't agree with you. No, listen, he doesn't believe that Jesus is Almighty God. He doesn't agree with you.
No.
You said it.
I will give it to you.
Respect his time, please. Respect his time.
Look. All you want to know. Where you want to know? We want it. Look, we want you to tell us Jesus. What is the position of Jesus Christ? As listen to me. As a Muslim, he was the prophet and Messiah. So you, if you either you are a Trinitarian or a non-Trinitarian, do you believe Jesus is the same as the Father? No, listen to me. You want to know? That, I don't want you all to digress that today. Jesus Christ, peace on him. As you said, John 1:1, he said it, you are digressing. Okay, I'm facing you. Okay. Now, what we want to tell you now, tell us Jesus Christ's position. Is he Almighty God who created
we
heavens and earth? No. No, what do you want to say? What I'm saying, you are not clear. You're telling me what is God in English. Listen to me.
Define God to me.
Listen to me.
And I will ask you, does Jesus Christ fit in that position?
Okay, listen.
Define God.
Okay, listen, let me define God. If you read your Bible, yeah? In the book of Exodus.
No, Bible.
I define God for you in Surah Ikhlas. You're not listening. Surah Ikhlas, are you listening?
You're just fooling yourself.
No. Look. Let me quote it again. Let me quote Ikhlas. No, I explained it. You're not listening. What did I say when I quoted a surah? From the Quran, Surah Ikhlas. Just quote me one, four verses.
You know, Shamsi ran away.
No, forget about Shamsi.
He ran away from this.
This guy is difficult.
This time, last week.
No,
Azim,
listen to me.
Look.
Define God. Okay. God, Almighty God. Let me define God. God.
I will tell you.
Almighty God, listen to me. Listen to me. Let me explain it simply, because with the Ikhlas, you're not listening. Almighty God has no beginning. No ending. He created everything. He has no partner. He has no son, no children, no father. He's unique. There is nothing unto like him. That's God. Nothing unto like him.
That's God.
Caught me. Yeah, that's God.
You are very wrong.
But I'm telling you. Let me finish. Let's go to the Bible now. He said I'm wrong. Let's go to the Bible. If you read the Bible, listen to me. If you read the Bible, in the book of Exodus 9:14, God said that you might know that there is none unto like me in all the earth. Do you believe in that? Do you believe in that?
Answer my question.
Let me kufan. No, listen to me. No. I'm defining God to you. I define the God. God is unique. there is nothing unto like him. And the Bible said that.
I know about that.
But So what I'm saying, what is the Jesus position? Is he God incarnate?
Allow him his time.
Is Jesus God incarnate?
He's divine and almighty.
Is he the same with the Father? No. Let me finish. Let me finish. Let me finish. Hold on. How many minutes? No, I'm saying. Okay, look. The Christians. You know what? No. You see, you are following the Athanasian Creed. Listen to me. And you don't. No. Now they are following the Christian. Millions of Christians are following it. You don't believe in Trinity. I want you to tell me, Jesus is the Almighty God. He's the Creator of the heavens and the earth. Is he unique?
Yes, I read you in John.
Jesus.
This guy. I'm here.
He has finished. He has submitted.
I'm going now because this guy waste of time.
He hasn't still answered my question.
You are not answering it. Listen to me. You see, no, your Bible here. Not your Bible here. I got my Quran. Your Bible here. Show us. Define God for me in the Bible. The Almighty God. No, the Bible is here. Hold it.
God.
Hold it.
God.
No. I don't want your opinion. Yeah, your opinion. It's claptrap. It's nonsense.
Matthew 28.
No. Okay. Go. I quoted a class. Not my opinion. No. I wanted to quote. I quoted a class. I quoted. You want the definition of God in Islam. I quoted. In the Bible is the definition of God.
Wait.
The definition of the Bible. You know. You don't know.
I will show me. You, both in the Quran.
We want to know who is Almighty God.
Both in the Quran.
I will show. Okay, show us.
First in the Bible.
Wait.
Can show
first in the Bible.
In the Bible.
I will show.
Show us.
I saw in the Quran.
Show us.
Okay.
Show us.
We want to know who is Almighty God. Who is the Creator of heaven and the earth.
Now.
Go ahead and show me.
From the definition of God, you fail.
Okay. I agree with you. Fail. You win. So you win. Show us now.
Ramification of God. But the definition of God, Jesus Christ is God. Then the question will now arise, which God is Jesus Christ if he's God?
No. You don't listen to me.
No.
We know who is the creator of the heavens and the earth, who created everything. Tell who is that person? Is it the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, or three of them? Quote your Bible. Man is panicking. My African brother. Oga, you're panicking. Oga is panicking. I can see. No evidence.
I've been able to define.
Your Bible says prove all things.
No.
1 Thessalonians 5:21. Prove all things.
Listen. Huh? What is Allah's name out of 99?
I've been able to define.
No. No, it's the finish. Want to know? No, forget about the finish.
Wait.
No. We don't want about that God, gospel, God. Who is the creator of heaven and earth?
First of all, have you agreed? The definition of God.
Okay, I agree with you. Okay, go.
You agree.
You're small coming. So who is the creator? Who is the creator of the heavens and the earth?
Wait, if you have agreed, this man, the definition of God.
My brother here, last week, Shamsi, exposed him, and now I'm exposing him.
Now,
what do you want to know? Who is the creator of heavens and earth? Who created us? So, brother.
Now, you have agreed that Jesus Christ is God.
No.
I will show you. See, I based on the truth.
What is the Bible?
I based on the truth. I'm not here to impose that Christianity.
Look, your scripture is here.
Right.
Ask us on the Quran. Allah is the creator. Now, show us who the creator. Can I quote the Quran? Allah is the creator of everything.
I know.
Show your Bible. You read the Bible.
I've read your Bible.
Okay, show us.
Okay,
just your Bible. Just your Bible. Show us. The Bible, who's the creator?
Intimidation.
Because he cannot.
See, I cannot be intimidated.
They said Jesus is God.
Yes.
Did he create anything?
Is he
the creator? Who's the creator?
Is
Jesus God?
No.
What did he create? Tell me.
No.
Who did he create? I'm here, Christians. What did Jesus create? Look. What did Jesus create?
Show us from the Bible.
Jesus created. According to the Bible. Created the heaven and the earth.
According to Bible, Jesus created. Yes. Okay, source. Hold on, come here. I know that. I know all that.
True God Almighty.
No, Jesus. Yeah, no. Hold on. Jesus created the heaven. heavens and the earth. No, let's see. Show us that. No, 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 look, look. The three Christians here, they're going to show me who is the creator.
In Genesis, yeah? In Genesis.
Yeah.
You know what?
It says that.
It's yeah. not about. This
no,
is not.
No, 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 no. You are running. I say you run.
When
I say you run away. No, no, no. Show us. No, evidence.
We should show.
There's not. There's not.
Nobody knows it all.
No, but show us. This is very important.
He has accepted.
He can't show me.
You
can't. Got your Bible on you. Show me. Oga, Oga, show me.
From my Bible, I will
show. Oga, show me.
I'm not running away.
Because you're running. I told you. I say you run away.
Jesus Christ.
You cannot.
The personality of Jesus Christ.
You see, they go to church. They brainwash them. You cannot. No proof. Prove all things.
Let me prove it.
Prove it. No way, prove it. No, 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 prove it.
I've been
you've been talking a lot. Okay, go on.
There's nothing I cannot show.
Okay, no, she's gonna prove it. No, no, you're evil. She's gonna prove it. Prove it.
All the quotation. I know every quotation.
No, you don't know nothing, man. Prove it. So quote them. You don't need quotation from here, quote it.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, yeah, no, last week, yeah, last week. Quote it then.
Jesus Christ.
Just quote it. No, you say quote it, you know the quotation.
Jesus Christ, listen. Do you want to listen or you just want to argue for argue's sake?
Okay, because you're not making point. Roger. I'm listening, you're not. Show me then.
You're not making me make point.
Show me, show me.
Yeah. So, Jesus Christ, before I'll show you, he said, Jesus Christ is God. He has accepted that. But Jesus Christ is not God Almighty.
He's not God Almighty.
Listen, listen, I will educate you. I said I will educate you.
But they believe that Jesus is a part of the Trinity.
I said I will educate you. Can you relax? Can you relax?
Okay, go.
Jesus Christ is God, which he has accepted.
No, no way.
Yes or no? He said he did it.
No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
But he said he accepted.
Listen to me, listen to me. Do you know what? Let me. Look, I've been quoting the Bible. Let me quote the Quran. Look. Let me quote one verse of the Quran.
We cannot get to anywhere like
now. Tell you what Quran says about Jesus.
Let me know.
He doesn't listen. So many here.
Wait,
I show him. I quote him there.
I quote him there.
Jesus is God. He knows.
Look, I'm going to go up there because I'm tired now.
Only one does not meet.
You see, I've got this. These guys are deluded. You see, they say Jesus is God, and I ask the creation, who created the heavens and the earth? In the Old Testament, Almighty God in the Old Testament says he's the only creator. I quote that verse all the time to them in the book of Isaiah, chapter 44, verse number 24. God said that I'm the Lord who made all things, who alone stretched out the heavens, who spread the earth by myself. There's no Trinity there, there's no Jesus there. The Bible in the Old Testament, the word Jesus is not there. This is the thing, they are deluded, so I'm tired now. Wa akradawana. والحمد لله رب العالمين